Hi, Jason with Tormach. Let's talk about how to use your Haimer to set up your work offsets. The first step to using your Haimer successfully is to making sure that it's properly calibrated. We did an entire video on this. If you haven't done this already, please check out that video. So the Haimer is kind of a unique edge finder. It allows you to set X, Y, and Z axis all with the same tool. So it's really a time saver when you're setting up your machine. So you can see on our dial face here, when we move the stylus over, we get the two indicator needles move with it. When we line both the small red needle up and the large black needle on zero, it compensates for the diameter of the ball. So it also makes it quicker since we don't have to remember what size, and it just kind of reduces some error opportunities. But it also works in Z. So to use this with Z, we need to set the tool length like we do all of our other tools. In our system, the way we like to teach tool offsets is the distance from the spindle nose to the tip of the tool. This tool is a little unique when you're comparing it to like a solid end mill. There's no compliance in an end mill. With the Haimer, there is some compliance, so we need to preload the Haimer to the zero location to make sure that we have an accurate length. So to measure the tool offset, you really just want to do the same process you're going to do to set all of your tools. So if you're going to use our height gauge, measure your Haimer at the height gauge. If you're going to use a piece of paper or touch the parts off and your tools off in your machine, then you want to set your Haimer the same way. Consistency is truly key when you're looking for accuracy while machining. So we're going to go ahead and show you how to do it on the granite block here. So what we do is we just put the height gauge down right on the top. We zero this out. And what this is representing in the machine's mind is the spindle nose. So we zero this out on the spindle nose, we raise it up, and we preload it. As we put tension on this, the easy way to do it is the height gauge has a little lock on it, so we can lock this top portion, then we can use the thumb screw to dial it down to zero. So then we just watch our face here as we dial down, and we just keep going until we make it to zero. So as you can see, we have 4.7655. One thing to note is if this is under tension, it is a spring tension, so if you don't put a little bit of pressure here, it can lift up the indicator, the height gauge base. So it's just kind of good practice just to kind of keep a little pressure here while you're checking your number. So just again, it's 4.7655. So once we have our number, then we can just enter that into the offset table in PathPilot. So we jump to our offsets tab. We go down to the tool number we want to enter it at. We're going to use tool 50. We're going to enter a description in here. So just put Haimer. And I'm going to enter my length offset at my 4.7655. And we just hit enter. The standard stylus on the Haimers is right about an inch long. They do make an optional long reach stylus, which is a little bit over 2 inches long. This is nice if you just need to reach down into a bore to set a zero. The ball diameter is larger on the long stylus. Since the Haimer compensates for that diameter on the small one, when we make that stylus longer, we need to make the ball bigger to compensate for the change in throw needed to put the indicator back on zero. So it's a great little tool to have in your toolbox if you need it, but just as a note, it does make the diameter larger, so something to keep in mind. So with the long stylus installed, I had a length of 6.4045. I'll go ahead and enter that in as another tool offset. So then if I need to switch to this stylus, I don't have to measure the tool later. I'll be able to just swap stylus back and forth on the same Haimer and use whichever one's appropriate. So we'll enter that length in here in the offset table as well. Let's make that tool 51. We'll just call it Haimer long and our 6.4045. So now whichever one I need to use, I can just activate the appropriate tool length and pretty quickly get my part set up. So you see, we're going to use the short one for the part we're setting up. So we're going to activate tool 50. I'll put the Haimer in the machine. So on this part, we're going to set this back left corner on the top as our zero, and then we'll also set the center of this pocket as a zero to show you guys how to find center of a bore or find center of a feature real quickly. So we're just going to go ahead and jog the machine over. Come over and we'll set our X position. So we're just going to jog down next to the side. I'm going to jog the machine over. And with the jog shuttle on the outer wheel, you can move it. The farther you move it, the faster it goes. So we can get somewhere quickly, and then we can slow down so that we don't break the tips off of these. So we'll walk it over as we start to see the indicator engage. When we almost get to zero, we'll stop. And then we'll switch to our center wheel. and we'll just dial this right over to zero. From here, we can really just hit X0. The Haimers compensate for the diameter and everything, so when you're on zero, you're on the edge of the part. It makes it real quick and easy to set your zeros. So we'll jog back on Y, bring it over, and we'll set our Y position the same way. And we'll say Y0. One thing to keep in mind and just to always think about while you're setting your zeros, make sure you have your tool lengths activated. I still get myself in this every once in a while. You just get in a hurry and you forget to do it. So always just double check to make sure that the appropriate tool is loaded. So we have tool 50 activated on Path Pilot. Then we can come down in Z and we can set our zero position. So we jog it close, walk it in nice and slow. We're right at zero there, so then we can say Z0. So you can see it's a real quick process with this tool. It's really kind of a fun, nice tool to use and have around the shop. Another nice thing about it and a great feature is it's really quick to set the center of a feature as a zero as well. Whether it's the center of a bore, if you're going to use the outside of this rectangular block to set it. Here we'll do the inside of this pocket. So we'll just bring it down, we'll come over in Y, we'll touch the edge of the part. We'll hit zero. And we're gonna jog the other side of the pocket. Walk it up to zero. And then right in our DRO on Pathfly here, we're going to select our box and we're just going to hit the right arrow to get to the end of it, and we're going to say divide by 2. And this is going to go ahead and do the math for us, putting the zero right on center. So really makes it quick and easy. The less you can do math throughout the day, the less opportunities you have to make mistakes. So I always, anytime the machine can do it for me, I am a big fan of letting it do the work. So we'll just do the same process here in X. Zero on the one side of the pocket. Find the other side, click on our DRO again, hit the right arrow, and then just say divide by 2. And that puts us on center. So now if we just jog the machine up to a safe position, we can jump to our MDI line, type in G0, X0, Y0, and the machine will move to the center. You can see we've found our zero position on center. So I hope this helps you guys use your Haimer effectively. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to our channel and check out our other videos. Check out this link to watch that footage. No, it didn't work. Check out. Oh, what's up?
That surprised me.
Shop life.